Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Venom Vlog. And today we're going to talk about, since we've been going through the Rick Remender, Agent Venom stuff, I thought this was pretty cool. He posted this the other day on Twitter, and he talked about how he originally had plans to do, a big crossover event. So I guess he wasn't planning to leave Venom, the comic book, around issue. I think he left around issue 21 or 22. So it looks like he wasn't planning to do that originally. He had a pitch for a storyline called War of the Symbiotes, which actually I think in Ultimate Comics, Brian Michael Bendis did a storyline I think called War of the Symbiotes as well. So the name has been kind of used before, but I guess Remender was just kind of going through and being like, we're setting stuff up. We spent a couple months setting up Eddie Brock as the new Toxin, which we haven't got to that point yet, so we will very soon. We got to get through Spider Island, and then once we do, we'll get into the Circle of Four stuff, and then after that, we'll get into the Eddie Brock stuff. So I'm looking forward to discussing that in those episodes with you guys. So this is kind of taking place after that. It's at near the end of his run. He wanted to do something where he would bring in symbiote hunters, which we do see those at some point. I think Cullen Bunn did some of that too, and I think that might have been established before. I can't remember, but yeah, there was other versions of symbiote hunters. And so this would be a story that was set in New York, and it dealt with Spider-Man, Venom, and eventually some symbiote hunters from outer space. And then so his plan was that since they spent 7 months building up Eddie as Toxin in the Venom comic, he was hoping to pay it off nicely with this new thing where he was going to have symbiotes have like a mating season in a way. Even though they don't mate with each other, they mate asexually, kind of like with themselves in a way. But they what they what the suit was going to go in heat. So the toxin suit basically was going to go into heat and start spreading spores all over, which I was like, oh, that's interesting, because that's there was kind of a little bit of that in Absolute Carnage, where Carnage was underground and he had these like pods or spores or whatever. And I think that was even also maybe not so much spores in the comic, but in the cartoon Spider-Man Unlimited, there was some spores that Carnage was laying out in that cartoon as well. So that's kind of funny that again with these ideas, I feel like a lot of writers, when they come on Venom, they kind of recycle stuff that's already been done unintentionally. I think that's the kind of the thing. I think maybe Donny Cates, to give him a little bit of credit or give him some slack, because I feel like a lot of stuff he does seems intentionally ripped off. But I think some of the times it's genuinely unintentional. Like I think it just happens with the character. I think everybody's like, oh, wouldn't it be cool if we did this, this, and this with Venom? And because either the editor hasn't read those old stories and doesn't know, or the writer themselves hasn't read those old stories and doesn't know, that maybe they're just like, all right, well, the history keeps repeating itself, and they keep telling similar stories over and over with Venom. I don't mind that when it's street level stories, but every time a cosmic story comes along, it's something like this where it's like, hey, let's just give everybody symbiotes and see what happens. And so I'm kind of glad on some level that this never happened by Rick Remender. Although I love Rick Remender and I think he would have done a great job at it. But I don't know. It's like, how many of those stories, like if they're doing it in the cartoon coming up, Maximum Venom, and I'm kind of okay with that because it's a different medium and it's being told in a different way. It's like 6 1-hour episodes, and it's in a different universe, and it's kind of set. The different things hopefully will happen in it and could happen in it. So I'm kind of looking forward to seeing like a different take on that to an extent. But in the comics, it's kind of been done ever since Planet of the Symbiotes. It kind of seems to be the go-to thing where it's like, hey, we're gonna do Venomize and Edge of Venomverse. And granted, those didn't happen till after this, so this could have been one of those moments where if it did happen, we would have at that point been like, all right, this hasn't happened too much. So that's the one credit I'll give here, is that if Remender would have done this in 2011, it would have been at a time where we've only gotten that story like once or twice, so it wouldn't have felt, so overdone. Now it feels way overdone. So reading it now, we're kind of like, oh man, another one of those. But I guess back then it would have, more of set the bar as opposed to being another similar bar, that a lot of people seem to dive into. So yeah, he talks about how he was going to have like different sections of the world. Like there was going to be this thing where Toxin was in heat. He sends out these spores. They start breeding, and then they start taking over different cities. And so symbiotes slowly start taking over the world. And I guess Carnage at one point was gonna, there was going to be warlords, and Carnage was going to be the warlord of New York. Or the King of New York. And I'm like, well, that sounds like very similar. Like Absolute Carnage seemed to have run with that idea a little bit, where you have, Carnage kind of taking over New York with a bunch of symbiotes running through the streets and taking over heroes and things like that. So that's kind of what it was. So it was a symbiote mass procreation is what was happening, and it began to spread on such a pace that it cannot be contained. Entire cities are overrun worldwide, creating new symbiote warlords in each city, Carnage was going to be the king of New York, overrun by symbiote infections. And then Remender goes on to say, war is waged. The superhuman community rallies together to try and combat the plague of symbiotes, but the symbiotes have spread at such a rate that heroes are bonded with as soon as they enter the battle. So as soon as like Captain America jumps into the battle, boom, he gets a symbiote. So again, it's all just happening really quickly. Like the heroes, Thing jumps into battle, Captain Marvel gets into battle. Before they even throw a single punch, boom, symbiote's right on top of them. And then I guess the story was going to end. Spider-Man was going to be a big part of it. So were the Avengers. And of course, Agent Venom, Flash was going to be a big part of the story. But I guess what he wanted to end it with was he was going to end with Eddie Brock making a sacrifice at the end of the story and dying to stop Toxin from continuing to spawn. So Toxin, I guess, because he's the 1,000th symbiote in the bloodline, I guess that's why he was the focus of this story and why he was so essential to spreading this symbiote, plague in a way, was because, he's now this new breed that, it's the thing that I like that on some level, because that was kind of set up by Peter Milligan, where it was like, even though I don't like those stories too much, like Venom vs. Carnage was an okay story where it introduced Toxin, but that Toxin miniseries afterwards I thought was terrible. But this version, I guess, was going to be what they set up in Peter Milligan's Venom vs. Carnage, where we got to kill, like Carnage wanted to kill Toxin because it was his offspring, but it was number 1,000 of symbiotes in their bloodline. And that was going to, it's been decreed that number 1,000 would bring, the end of something, it'd be catastrophic to let it live. It looks like this was going to pay that story thread off, which I like that. I like that he was, going to be like, oh, here's that continuity. Let's finish it off here. So that's neat. But Eddie Brock dying at the end, I don't know if I would have liked that. Hopefully Marvel would have stopped him from doing it if he ever got to do this story, but he never did, unfortunately. And I wouldn't want to see it now. That's the thing, is maybe that's why I'm looking at it this way. It's like, we already have enough. We had, Edge of Venomverse and Venomverse and Venomized, Poison X, all those storylines were just back to back to back by Cullen Bunn. Then we have Absolute Carnage, and then we had Carnage, I think USA had, some of the Avengers get Carnage suits on them. So it's like, we've had that. That story's been done. I kind of don't. So I saw some people going online like, can you still do this? Will you make this a series? And I'm kind of like, no, don't make it a series. Like it's great that you had this idea. It would have been cool to come out at the time when you made this book in 2011. But I don't think now it would just be, like I said, it wouldn't set the bar. It would just be another bar. There's already a bunch of bars that have told that story. And that one, I don't know, maybe it could be better. It could be a higher bar, but because it's Remender and I love his stuff, but looking back, I'm like, all right, if this would have came out then, I probably would have loved it. And I probably would have stayed on the book. Because if you remember, I stayed on the Agent Venom book for a while, but I actually dropped out after Circle of Four, not because I didn't like it, but it was, I don't know what was going on in my life then. Unfortunately, my memory's too terrible. But at some point after Circle of Four, I remember I got all those books and then I dropped the book after that. And then I didn't come back in until years later when Mike Costa jumped back on. So I missed all the Agent Venom stuff, but now I own it all and I'm going back and we're talking about it on the show now. So that's been kind of nice to go back and experience something for the first time on this show with you guys. And a lot of you who are Agent Venom experts, it's kind of nice to have the roles reversed, where I'm like, oh, I know a lot about Eddie Brock and we went through all those stories, but now I'm like the student and it kind of feels kind of fun. So, but I don't know. I feel like if this event came out at the time, I may have stayed on board, or who knows, I may have pushed away, because like I said, I'm not a big fan of Venom focused events. Maximum Carnage was fine because it crossed over Spider-Man titles, but if they would have made a Maximum Carnage miniseries to go with those tie-in issues, like that would have been too much and I probably would have peaced out. So self-contained stuff I don't mind too much, especially if it's on books I'm already collecting. And it sounds like this could have been that, but it also could have been something bigger where they tied into Avengers books and Spider-Man books and other things, and I wasn't reading the Avengers stuff at the time, so I don't know if I would have enjoyed a crossover like that. But still, the story never happened. Remender did write Venom for 22 issues. It remains a well-guarded run that helped cement Flash's Agent Venom persona as a fan favorite, which is true. And this is from comicbook.com, so I'll put a link to this article down below. And then also Rick Remender's Twitter, it's on here. So when you go to this article, you can just click on his post and go and read his pitch there as well. And he did come up with a mock image, because I guess he's on quarantine. So he's like, yeah, I'm at home, I don't have much to do, so here's War of the Symbiotes. Here's my, here's like a mock image I made of Captain America with symbiote, stuff on him. So I'll put that image up here because it looks pretty cool. And then I'll flash the, his actual text that he posted on Twitter too. I'll put that up there as well. So he's at Remender on Twitter. if you want to follow him on there, because he's been posting a lot of stuff, like a lot of ideas he never got to do, like X-Men and a couple other things that he never got a chance to fully realize, you know, during his time at Marvel. So yeah, it's pretty neat. I like when writers do that and they're like, hey, I'm going to go back in my vault and find some old stories that I never got to do, and I'll share them with you guys, especially during a time like this where a lot of us are just kind of, you know, wanting new stuff, you know, like wanting to hear ideas and stuff because we're not getting comic books weekly anymore. And on that front, if you are on Comixology, and if you don't, you know, feel free to get a free account on Comixology. Marvel is giving out 12 free comics right now. I think it's like The Kree Skrull War, which is a good one if you're a Venom fan, because First Host, if you have that miniseries, it ties into the Kree Skrull War. So definitely pick up Kree Skrull War. That's a great Avengers crossover. The Dark Phoenix Saga is on there. Donny Cates' Thanos Wins is on there. There's some Captain Marvel stuff on there. There's, I think, Spider-Man Red Goblin. So if you want to see the end of the Flash Thompson storyline, man, so heartbreaking. We'll get to there. We'll get there in a couple months. We'll get there. But yeah, if you want to read that storyline where, you know, that leads into Absolute Carnage, where, you know, Norman Osborn gets the Carnage symbiote, that's on there for free and has the whole entire run of it. So yeah, there's like 12 great graphic novels that Comixology is giving out for free for people right now because we're all in quarantine. So hopefully you guys are staying safe out there. I'm glad I can make a couple videos for you today. And I'm wishing you all to, you know, keep being safe and you know, stay indoors and just, you know, let us get ahead of this. Let the doctors who are out there sacrificing their lives get ahead of this and help each other and help people. And then, you know, hopefully we can, in a couple months, get back to normalcy. But you know, I appreciate you guys sticking with me and being patient with me and waiting for these episodes. And I was, you know, I had trouble wanting to make episodes. I probably could have started episodes a couple days ago, but I just, with everything going on, it's hard. And then I, you know, a friend of mine wrote me and said, hey, you know, you're not going to be able to get through this because I'm on my phone every day. I'm on TV just watching updates of, you know, what's happening in the world. And not that I'm obsessed, but I guess I just want to know what's happening. And it's weird to see the world like this, I guess, for me, because I grew up, I wasn't living in the States during the AIDS epidemic in the 80s. I was off in Greece, and I didn't come back here till after that had died down. So I've never actually been through something like this, where, you know, and even then, I, you know, I mean, I don't know if they did quarantines and stay at home stuff back then either. But yeah, we're doing it now, and it's just, all we're trying to do is just make sure we cut down the spreading of it, obviously. And that's the whole goal, is just to get ahead of it. So that way, if we do get sick later, you know, there's treatment and there's ways to get treated, and we can, you know, get taken care of. So yeah, I don't want to go off on a tangent about that, but I just know it's changed a lot of our lives. It's changed comic books, it's changed movies, it's changed a lot. But a friend of mine said, you know what, it shouldn't change you doing something to get you through the day either. And that's what this show is. It's a way for me to connect to you guys. And I said, you know, that's true. Cause I was going to make an announcement and be like, hey, no more Venom vlogs for like the month of April. I'll review Maximum Venom later. And I was going to just take a break and just focus on my book. And I am still doing that. And I am doing podcasts for Patreon. I'm a little behind on them, but I'm catching up. But I did want to address it and say that there was a moment where I might not have done this show for a little while. And I know that a lot of you guys would have understood, but when a friend of mine said, hey, he's like, dude, just, you know, if it helps you get through the day, be a little selfish in that regard and put stuff up for you, because I'm just sitting around here, you know, checking my phone and, you know, and looking at my book a little bit and then checking the news, and it's not very healthy. And so, you know, and I don't want to start off this new, you know, life, this new chapter in my life, on an unhealthy note. I want to get back to doing things that, you know, make me happy and help me connect to you guys. So hopefully you guys are enjoying the three episodes that we posted this week, and I'll try to get more episodes to you guys very, very soon. I'll do these three now, and then maybe I'll do like two or three more in a day or two. It's very hot. I have to turn off all the fans and close all the windows, so you'll see that I might sweat in some of these videos. It gets really hot in here, and I have a very little light on, because when I put the big light on, I was just drenched. It's hot in Florida, man. But what we'll do is I'll try to record these at night. Maybe it'll be a little cooler at night, and maybe I can, you know, have a little bit more energy. But yeah, three's all I can do today because it's just too hot. But I'll get more to you guys very, very soon. So thank you so much for watching these videos. Let me know what you think of Remender's idea. Would you have liked to see, you know, to seen this? Would you have, you know, I don't know. I think I would rather have stories than not have them, mostly, even if I didn't don't like them. But I do like that this would have been neat, because in 2011, it wouldn't have felt, you know, redundant. If it came out now, it would feel redundant. We get a lot of those stories now where Venom is just like, hey, let's just do stories where everybody gets symbiotes. It's like that seems to be the go-to thing now with Venom. Where symbiotes are taking over the planet. It's like those same stories all the time. I would rather I'd rather not another one like that come out now, but at least at this time it would have come out in 2011. It would have probably been a more of a trendsetter than a trend follower. So what do you guys think of it? You know, do you like the ideas? Let me know down below what you would have liked to see in Remender's run, and we'll discuss more down there. Thanks so much for watching the show as always. Like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see y'all in the future. Peace.